understand?
The only way to the title is through me.
Fight Night Champion, baby.
That's what champion.
Welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Husky Boy. Make sure you hit that like. Make sure you hit that subscribe. That notification icon, baby. We gonna get into it. Just check this out real quick. Oh, what is this? What are you talking about? We should still be fine, even though I'm using the controller on the PC, but just make sure that's good. Should be. Oh, okay. Bam. Let's get into it. I'm just gonna do a regular one, see if my controller is working. Oh, it has me as controller too. Alright, let me just switch it over. We don't wanna be controller 2, we wanna be controller 1. Xbox controller. Right, I mean that should work. Be showing you guys some gameplay today and some tips and tricks to get better. Alright, we back. We are back. Now, let's see what's going on up in here. Sure everything's good. Alright, let's get it. Yep, if you're on my channel, you will see me eat a lot. Wendy's chicken sandwich. All right. Let's go middleweight. See what we can find.
Anybody on Fight Night? Oh, let's browse strong then. Big piece of lettuce. Okay. Mr. Aggie. Hey, let's try this again. Spicy. I'll go with AJ. Archie Robinson. Okay, Mr. Archie Robinson.
Good evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and welcome to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip.
By far my favorite
Las Vegas, Nevada
game. There's no other game that I like better.
Five rounds of heavyweights. This should be a good one tonight. Both fighters say they are primed.
Something about boxing.
Off a very intense and passionate
Archie Robinson is 0-0-0-0.
He's got
zero.
His eye on the prize. Look at that,
that
focus
mean
and determination
anything.
During his ring walk.
Anything can happen. A little bit different than UFC.
Ryan's ring walk is one of those ring walks where you realize how attentive
47 and 32 and 30.
This is a guy who has his eye on the prize and nothing will distract him.
Their record is misrepresentation. Oh.
Introducing first in the blue corner. Coming out of London, the Dark Destroyer. And his opponent across the ring. Coming
yeah,
out
Anthony
of
Joshua.
London, the Lion.
Okay. Let's go.
They are scheduled for five. Round one underway. So many have said they're going to get right to business. Let's see if they go at it.
Already you can tell the size difference.
See, he's got his guard up really well that time, and it protects his head.
trying to do is box him from the outside.
Reaching the halfway mark of this round.
Excuse my
pulls
length.
The trigger right away with the left hand after getting tagged himself. Big shot. The right came clean. Right hand over the top. Very accurate with it. Good counterpunch. I loved how he moved off to the side and landed it.
Why would he?
Oh, that's gotta hurt.
He why would he down. Pick him?
Now, man. Can he beat the count?
I was quick. That was way too quick. Whoa.
Down he goes, now up he gets.
And if he wants to stay up, he's going to have to grab on, kill a little time.
I don't think he has a chance with that, dude.
Round comes to an end. We saw the knockdown there in that round, a little bit of a momentum gain.
Yeah, obviously it gives you confidence, but you know what?
All right.
It can also be a momentum killer, believe it or not.
Yep.
How so?
Joe, I've had guys where the worst thing that happened to him in a fight was when they scored the knockdown.
I think he realized.
Because they thought it was just going to keep happening.
He was way out of his
league. And they thought about only the punch they landed, not how they set it
up. RMS Arch.
So they got away from the game plan.
Man. Maybe if you was watching this video, RMS, you would, learn some things. This is just how I play, Fightnight Champion. Different ways people go about it. A lot of spammers. A lot of cheating. I like to keep it clean. Hey, shout out to Nintendo. Okay, we got to fight, people. Stephen Hunt. Mike Tyson off the rip. Okay, mate. Oh, let me pick somebody here, Mr. Mike. I'm looking for Vander Holyfield. Holyfield Tyson. Let's go. Okay. Bring me back to the 90s, baby.
Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas. Good evening and welcome to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada for our main event. 10 rounds of heavyweight action.
Okay. 15-29, 250 losses.
We spoke with both 10-11 yesterday. Fireworks anticipated here tonight. Let's see. Mike Tyson.
Oh, we got a little spammer here.
Belies his ring walk
we don't know.
He is ready for action.
I've called out a lot of YouTubers.
Vander Holyfield,
some of them respond, some of them don't.
The stuff of legend.
The
and
ones that
the
have
intensity on his face.
They know what it is. By the way, let's go.
Well, they've been waiting for this moment, and now they get it. Round one underway.
All right, so we got somebody who's coming straight forward. A lot
Teddy,
of pressure.
An obvious height discrepancy here. Got a real tall guy against a short guy. Right off the bat, advantage tall guy, but not necessarily, right?
Not necessarily. Look, on the outside, if he's able to control those quarters, yeah, he has an advantage.
Trying
but once the shorter man closes the gap a little bit and he gets in close, guess what? There's a lot of target in front of him.
Oh,
Holyfield with a block.
Use that jab.
Okay. Hey, you got some of that too. Let's go.
Halfway through round number one.
Some distance. Probably gonna be off
fight. By Evander Holyfield.
Unless start to slow him down.
You need to hit that head movement.
And now a well-placed hook to the head. Needs to improve that accuracy, miss with the headshot. That's a big uppercut that just crashed home. Good looking right hand. Ooh. After he got hit.
All that pressure.
And you see what he can do.
Watch
when
him
he sends that right to the head.
Watch him now.
You look at those punch stats and you say, okay, Mike Tyson's the busier man.
He's probably going to do that every single round.
It doesn't take much for him to get rid of a guy.
No, because you know.
Unless
that
he starts to get tired.
To
so what you want to do is just stay calm.
And he's looking to do it with one Let's shot. Go.
Stay
right
calm, reserve your energy.
You want this fight?
Don't really worry about the scorecard.
Let's get moving out there. This guy.
Here we go. Round two is underway.
Oh, yeah.
Good body shot. The right hand came home.
He knows he exerted a lot of energy, so he's probably going to try to catch me with the right hand coming in. Oh, there it is. Oh, now he's going to stuck the box, which is what I want.
Come on, kid, focus. Body shot.
The defense pays off as he gets rid of that downstairs. Not able to land the uppercut. Tyson's putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination. Halfway through round number two. Teddy, I've heard you say it a million times early on in a fight. If there's any one piece of good advice you can give, it's start depositing it into that bank. Go to the body.
Yeah, because the interest comes later, and you're going to see the payoff in the late round.
He's coming forward now.
And there he counters back against his opponent. He scored well after being hit himself. Iron Mike with a big uppercut. Mike Tyson's at his best when the combinations are landing. He scored well there with that combo. He just missed that shot up top.
Hit the butt!
Mike Tyson with a big right hand. Now he's targeting
he's
upstairs.
He's throwing that thing.
Tyson's ability to get to his man paid
a lot of power
there. He damaged him in that round. He digs in with an uppercut after blocking that shot away.
You're not focused.
How about that? Another right hand.
More pressure.
And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Crafty counter punching.
More right hands.
Oh boy, big shot up top.
Let's see some more head movement.
And that's what fighters do. Pulls the trigger right away after taking one. Big left
Not
hand from Iron Mike.
Oh, he's throwing headbutts. He might get frustrated.
Comes right back with a shot of his own. Accurate jab brings the right hand. Tyson's making for a clinic here in combination punching.
Well, the first couple punches here, Joe, they're throwaway punches to really set up the payoff down the road. You see the third punch, the fourth punch, the fifth punch.
Let him throw all that punches.
Wind up landing.
All right hands. lot of power. Back to boxing.
Fine work with the double jab downstairs.
You're doing great.
Mike Tyson's punch didn't come close. See, that's what you want from his left hand. That's exactly what it should be doing, that left hand by Mike Tyson.
Ooh, there it goes again.
Return to sender. He gives him back one of his own. Tyson's left landing well. Evander Holyfield's the kind of boxer that wants to do just that. Find the target.
He just keeps throwing them.
Working, land both punches. He's been on target with his attack. Good, accurate punching as we begin round number four here, and he's up 3-0 on your scorecard, Teddy.
Good counter punching. And when you're counter punching the right way, you're usually getting clean shots. He's getting them.
Holyfield's coming through now beautifully. That's the combination punching he wants to put forth. You know, we see that he's made a stylistic change after being stunned here in this fight. But what about his opponent? Does his opponent have to make a change as well?
Well, he's got to adapt too. If he sees that what was working before for him has been taken away because the guy changed now, you know, he's made corrections. Well, he's got to find another way, another offensive, you know, opening, another offensive way to get to the guy. Got to be right with him.
Keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head. Tyson's being very efficient right here. I mean, he's just picking his shots. His accuracy is through the roof.
Well, that's one of the talents, and you hope is a talent of a top fighter, is his ability to pick his shots, to be calm enough to see the opens. He's seeing everything right now.
Halfway through round number four.
He got to get tired.
Tyson's landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best.
A lot of pressure.
Takes one, gives one. The right hand scores well.
I'm going to keep depositing into
and
that
now
body.
He's targeting upstairs.
Keep your distance. Back to body.
Here goes again. I don't know, Mr. Tyson.
Good job on the two-punch combo by Evander Holyfield. Evander Holyfield's banged by an uppercut.
Oh. It's lagging a little bit.
Don't stay in one spot.
Out of power.
Tyson digs deep with a
it seems like they're
Tyson's putting on a display
not as strong anymore.
The punch numbers tell that story.
You gotta stay busy out there, all right? Because you're losing this fight. Why? Because you're not throwing any punches at me.
I'm five. Let's go.
Another round. Will it go in another one-way direction? It's been a one-sided fight so far tonight. Really a lot of consistency from him with the right hand.
Move your head.
Covers up nicely, gets rid of his opponent's body shot. Do you see any way in which he can take his opponent's aggression and turn it against him?
Yeah, the perfect way. I mean, boxing 101, counterpunching. You got a guy coming at you,
more power.
No better way than to change his
That's
mind. Make him miss, make him pay.
Putting his punches together now. That's a nice combination. He returns the favor with a right hand of his own. Mike Tyson's jab lands well. And another right hand comes in. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. And now he scores well with the straight right.
Out of punches.
Use the rings. Protect yourself.
Tyson's really in position to control things in this fight if he can do what he did just there, and that's land a good solid jab. He gets hit, but he gives it right back. Right hand downstairs. Mike Tyson's punch is far off the target. Oh, he is stunned. He could go down.
He's in a
real, real bad spot right now. Maybe a punch or two and he could be on the deck. Oh, boy. He's got to get right to the inside. Just go bear hug this guy.
Either that, Joe, or maybe as big a long shot as this might be, his opponent now is coming in there not worrying about him at all. And he's leaving himself a little bit open. Maybe he can land a bomb. He can land a lucky shot.
Tyson's corner has very little to do right now. Why? Because their fighter has been nearly flawless with his accurate and clean
change
punch.
Himself,
well, part of that's attached to his personality. He doesn't waste anything. He's real calm. He's a conservative guy. Anything he throws, he's placing where
he's
going
to go back to boxing. You know, he exerted a lot of energy trying to take me out early.
Holyfield's doing exactly what he told us he would do. Now, he was stunned earlier in this fight, but he's sticking to that game plan.
You know, I like that. You know, I want to see how a guy behaves under pressure. He hasn't panicked, you know. He still believes in his identity, believes in his talents, his abilities, and he's going to stay that way unless the guy convinces him later on. Ooh.
He can't help himself.
Iron Mike with an iron right. Holyfield's lack of defense right now is showing up. His opponent's scoring with the right hand consistently.
Yes, he's found the target for that early on, and he's just staying with it. Nothing fancy.
Evander Holyfield's hitting the mark right now. How precise was he there with that three-punch combo? Tyson's staying away from trouble. He's out there on the outside. And that had some bite to it, that right hand by Mike Tyson.
Oh, he's trying to headbutt.
Good smooth work by Evander Holyfield. That's classic counter punching.
Yeah, what he did was he pulled that right shoulder back. You know, he just pulled it back, gave him the left shoulder, and then gave him the right hand.
I'm standing right here. You can go blow for blow. His energy has to be very depleted.
What a difference from corner to corner.
He's throwing a lot of punches.
He knows that he is in complete control of this fight, peppering his opponent with power shots.
Well, it's been like that all night long. Anything he throws finds a target.
Holyfield showing a little bit of a defensive shell, but Teddy, I'm seeing punches still getting through and splitting that guard.
Yeah, well, that's the problem, Joe, when you put those earmuffs on, but you don't move your head. Some of them are going to get through. And
what a big shot. Wow.
And that power punch.
Upstairs.
2, 3, 4, get up. 5, 6.
I'm going to get up. Definitely going to get up.
Evander Holyfield's back up on his feet. Let's see what he has now. Super two-punch combo by Evander Holyfield. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. Halfway through the seventh round. A well-placed left hand up top.
Up and down, side to side.
People like this are just annoying.
That is exactly what the corner wanted to see. A good combination punch by Evander Holyfield.
A lot of energy.
Evander Holyfield still shaking after feeling that uppercut. That is a big right hand after eating one himself. Took a shot. Now he gives the left. Scored well up top. Fires right back at him.
He has to be almost done.
Evander Holyfield tagged.
Mike Tyson's been able to avoid having any of his opponent's headshots landing flush.
And what his opponent has to do, Joe, is make an adjustment. What we used to tell the fighters, when a guy's elusive like this fighter is right now, you have to shorten your punches up. shorten them up a little bit, have less space to travel. They have a better chance of getting to that elusive target.
He wins every round.
Teddy's scorecard through seven rounds.
But as you can see, his energy is looking
by a significant margin. But Teddy, do that again. I think he's still a fresh fighter. How do you see it?
That's the problem. I see it the same way. And I'd be asking him a question. Why are you fresh? What do we come here to do? Just to waltz around, or did we come here to fight, to win?
Relax, relax.
He missed with that headshot. Commits to the straight right.
Good work.
And now he's targeting upstairs.
Let's move.
And he's really doing a nice job of hitting the mark with the jab.
And that's exactly what he needs. And it's not hard to hit the mark when the mark's coming at you. The right choice of a punch.
Very accurate two-punch combo by Evander Holyfield. Holyfield's way off the mark. That punch didn't have a chance.
Finish with the hook.
Hits him in the mug with the right. Tyson so dangerous with that accuracy, a two-punch combination landing. Holyfield's a seasoned pro, and old pros tend to fall into the same pattern. Nothing has changed with him stylistically since he's been knocked down in this fight.
Well, that falls right into that pattern or that cliche where old dogs can't be taught new tricks. Well, right now, he's going to have to come up with a trick or two, maybe, to survive this moment.
Good defensive skill with the block by Mike Tyson. And the round
boy threw over 1,000 punches.
Tyson's in dominating form here tonight. He's doing everything he wanted to do, and he's ahead on our scorecards ringside.
Yeah, but don't forget, he's in the other guy's hometown. So don't let up too soon. Don't start partying too soon. You know, still keep doing the things you were doing to get you to this place.
I really like what he's doing here. I mean, if you were to pick any one piece of weaponry that you say aligns with what he is strategically as a fighter, it is the jab, and he's firing it off beautifully.
And he's firing it off consistently all night at the right distance. He's getting full extension on that punch, and that's making him effective offensively and safe defensively. He's out of the other fighter's range.
He comes with a straight right hand.
He looks very depleted.
You see him with the left of the head there?
Here's your feet.
Good biting, snapping shot by Mike Tyson.
Combo, combo.
Evander Holyfield's right hand scores well. Evander Holyfield's movement helped out there. He avoided that punch. Return the sender with the left hand. Evander Holyfield once again the target of a hook. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand scores. What a smart combination by Evander Holyfield. Able to dismiss his opponent's shot.
Man, how's this dude still standing?
With an uppercut.
There we go. He has to be, like, done.
Fine looking right hand by Evander Holyfield. Teddy, he did a smart thing right there. Just created enough space and then landed.
Oh!
And banging away he
and I go down.
He goes down.
How does that happen?
May be close here. Can he survive the round?
Three, four, five.
We got one more round.
Wow! Saved by the bell! That's like something
we
out
have
of a 70%. Movie here.
Yeah, except nobody's coming in there and saying cut. You know, he
Let's
has
go.
To keep going here. Right now, the only thing he knows is he's got flashbulbs going off in his head.
My turn.
A little something for his opponent after getting tagged. More than one punch downstairs. That can be damaging. Little head knocking with that right hand. Evander Holyfield with the big uppercut.
Yeah, he has to be done.
Evander Holyfield's on the bad end of a very impressive hook up top. Not able to land the headshot.
Woof.
Takes one to give one. He comes back with a right hand.
Holyfield's going about this in a completely different way. He was knocked down, and now he's abandoned everything
this is modded
that he trained
up
to this point to do. He just threw the game plan away, Teddy.
Tyson stumbled back. He just got hurt. He got rocked. He just got rocked, and he's still taking punches.
The only way right now is
he's definitely modded.
Stop this flow.
Showing that he's got some defense of his own. He got away from that punch. Big shot up off the deck and now in control. He scores a knockdown.
They have some time to finish him.
And he turned it around because when his opponent scored the knockdown, he got a little careless, a little lazy.
Able to show you his blocking ability. Nice block that time. It was intended to the head. Keeping his hands up, getting way of his opponent's effort. Completely
super modded
fight. At least that's the way we saw
you gotta love these guys.
If you saw it any other way, you'd have to put a warning out the next time these judges judge a fight, kind of like on a pack of cigarettes. You know, this could be hazardous to your health. I mean, these guys could be hazardous to your career if they scored any other way.
Here's the official decision.
Oh, I'm so happy you guys can be witness to the things that go on and that's really what's going on in this game now. A lot of spammers, man. That's part of the game. Someone to help me. Mr. Goat Squad 243-1-2413-01.
Please, Mr. Bossman, I need this job more than you know. But he gave me my last paycheck and he sent me on out the door. Well, I need a dollar, dollar, dollar. That's what I need.
Hey, hey. Joe Frazier. And if I share with you my story, would you share your dollar with me? I mean, I'll go Ali. I don't know if I'm walking on solid ground. Ali, Joe Frazier. Everything around me is crumbling down. All I want is someone to help me. Okay. The greatest, ladies and gentlemen. The greatest.
Good evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas welcoming you to the New York City Arena here in Midtown Manhattan. Our main event should be a good one tonight. 10 rounds among heavyweights. Each man comes into this fight supremely confident, expecting to deliver a W. Muhammad Ali's coming down to the ring right now, and he does so with a certain gamesmanship. Putting forth that attitude to his opponent, telling him, I'm the man, and I know it. Opening round, scheduled for 10. Good double jab by Muhammad Ali.
Just like it, just like it.
Oh, there we go.
Most people in a matchup like this, Teddy, outside versus inside fighter, would say, well, the jab's going to play a critical role for the outside fighter. But it can work the other way.
You know, a jab is such a great weapon, but if it's not thrown at the right distance, at the right speed, at the right time, it could be a way for the outside fighter to get in quick, time a right hand over a jab, maybe a slow jab.
There's no need to be on the inside.
Okay, a lot of pressure.
Well played, straight right hand. Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Well placed, well timed combo up top.
Okay.
Good solid right hand by Joe Frazier. Able to block that away. It was targeted for his head.
Keep it going.
Doubling up the jab by Muhammad Ali. Blocks that punch. Frazier's left working well that time.
Finish with the hook. Get close
to him. Close. Gotta clinch him up
and
for a little bit.
And he just holds on there. Body shot. And now he brings the left hand upstairs. And a punishing hook by Joe Frazier. Last 10 seconds of this first round. Right back to the belt line. Solid right by Joe Frazier.
Don't let him get at you.
End of
a lot of pressure
one.
Coming in. You got to try to hold your stamina.
I want you. Use the ring.
And try to make it to later on in the fight.
Here we go. Round two is underway. Joe Frazier needs to just bulldoze his way in and start clinching after being dazed. Oh, that's good stuff. Fired right back with one of his own. Good work by Joe Frazier. He clinches when he gets to the inside.
He just utilizing distance.
Beyond
that
the
jab.
Left hook of Joe Frazier, what else is he capable of doing?
Making you miss and setting up that left hook. Bobbing and weaving. We don't think about that with Frazier.
You're not
going to
beat mods.
Bobbing and weaving creates holes. Holes that
do,
are filled with that hook.
It happens rarely.
And coming upon the halfway mark of this three-minute round.
With anything. They call of Duty when you play.
Combination by Muhammad Ali.
Working the body.
Blocks the headshot. Frazier's able to avoid that punch. A little head hunting never hurt. Does it with the hook. He's committed to that left hand, and it's working out. Ali's showcasing one of the best weapons you can have.
There he goes, right hand.
To set the tone.
Come on, man.
Yeah, and he's shown that it does more than just set up other punches.
This game is infested, man. And SAG is my favorite game.
You know, it just throws the other guy's rhythm off, and that's what he's doing a good job of.
Unable to make an impact there by Muhammad Ali.
Double up your jab. All right, breathe, deep breath. Get some more.
I'm gonna take this round off.
Frazier's recuperative powers are proving to be very strong right here. This is the start to the round he wanted to have, coming off a round where he was clearly damaged.
Let him tee off on me. Save some of this energy for later. Keep him away from me.
Scoring with the right hand by Joe Frazier.
Utilize this ring. He's probably like, what the hell, man? Gotta utilize his ring. Oh, he quit. I tell you, man. Well, that's a dub for us. Definitely a dub for us. He quit. He just quit. One game, one desire, one flame, one bonfire, let it burn higher. I never show man, you want to fight tired, I'm the smart, you know. Sucks because I wanted this to be a tips and tricks video. But I ended up fighting people who it's literally impossible to even try to explain how to defend yourself with spammers. Biggest tip is hold that stamina all the way to the end and let the boxing gods be with you. Because we all know it's very hard to beat bots. But this is Husky Boy and I'm out. Like and subscribe to the channel. Jesus.